Hello everyone. The Antminer Universal Test Fixture is a practical tool for quickly detecting faults in hash boards. Today, we'll learn how to use this fixture. First, let me introduce its interfaces and buttons. The black one is the power switch of the tester. And the green one is the test button. This is the port for inserting the 12 volts power cable. If the hash board to be tested is from the 9 series, this port must be connected to power the test fixture. The front of the fixture has a display screen where test results are shown. There are 4 ribbon cable ports for connecting the test fixture to the hash board, and all of them are usable. Next, there are 4 fan ports. Do not connect fans to these ports while testing hash boards, as it might damage the fixture. This is a 6P power port. If we are testing a hash board from an all-in-one machine, the miner's own PSU cable should be plugged into this port. Here is the USB port for connecting the tester to a computer, used for displaying test logs. To test the hash board of an all-in-one machine, the 4P voltage regulating cable of the miner's PSU must also be connected to this port, which powers voltage to the fixture. This is the network port, which is not needed for testing hash boards. This slot is for inserting a TF card loaded with test files. To test different models of hash boards, we only need to change the test files on this card. Today, I will demonstrate the testing method using an Antminer S19J Pro hash board. Step 1. Install the conversion and test files. Insert the TF card into a card reader. Format it on a computer. Copy and paste the S19 conversion file to the TF card. Then insert the TF card into the slot and power the fixture. During this process, we can use this interface to power on the test fixture. Attention! When installing the conversion file, the screen of the fixture will light up, but not display anything. If the indicator lights flash at least 5 times, it means the file is successfully installed. If the jig is normal, all 3 indicator lights will be on. Otherwise, there may be a problem. Remember, when we use the test fixture, not to touch the power unit part of the fixture with your hands, as it might burn out it. The following: turn off the power. Remove and reformat the TF card. Then copy and paste the S19J Pro test file to the TF card. Reinsert the TF card into the slot. And turn on the switch. When the version number of the hash board appears on the display screen, it means the test file is successfully installed. Step 2. Connect the fixture, hash board, and computer cables. To test the S19J Pro hash board, we need to use the APW12 power supply, which powers both the tester and the hash board. This is a 4P voltage regulating cable on the power supply. Plug it into this port. Then connect the 6P power cable here to power the fixture. Next, connect one end of the hash board ribbon cable to the test fixture. This is the USB cable. Green goes into the R pin, black into the URT pin, and white into the T pin. All connections for the fixture are now complete. Then plug the other end of the USB cable into the computer. Find the device manager on the computer. Double-click port COM5. and confirm in the port settings that the baud rate is this one. Now open the serial port software. I'm using Hyperterminal here, but other testing software is also okay. Click plus to open the serial port. And confirm that the serial port here is consistent with the computer parameters. Step 3. Connect the hash board and start testing. We need a cooling fan to cool the hash board. First, power the fixture to complete its self-check. When this content appears on the serial port software, it means the test fixture has completed its self-check, and the hash board version will also appear on the fixture screen. Next, continue to connect the hash board ribbon cable and power cable. The order of connection here is very important, followed by the negative power cable, the positive power cable, and the hash board cable. Incorrect connection may burn out certain components on the hash board. After testing, disconnect these cables in the reverse order: ribbon cable, positive power cable, and negative power cable. Everything is ready. Press the test button to start testing the hash board. Okay, when these results appear on the serial port, it means that the test has been completed. Well, the above is how to use the maintenance tool Antminer Universal Test Fixture. If you have any questions, please leave a message in the comment area. Thank you all.